but the streets of fairness and respect unity do not protect themselves. I will talk about a major event from three parts of my life. A moment in my adolescent year.
Namaste.
Hari Om. Namaskara.
So, can you see the screen?
Oh, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Let's start. ॐ वक्रतुण्ड महाकाय सूर्यकोटिसम प्रभ निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाविव संपृक्तौ वागर्थः प्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ धातु ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृति कृत्स बंतादि धातु ब्रह्मात्मने नमः. सो लास्ट टाइम वी सॉ थ्री प्रयोगास. देर आर थ्री प्रयोगास इन संस्कृत. द वे यू हैव एक्टिव वॉइस पैसिव वॉइस. सिमिलरली यू हैव एक्टिव वॉइस इज कर्तरी प्रयोग एंड passive voice is karmani prayoga. There is something called as bhavi prayoga in Sanskrit, which is basically it is just the dhatu. It is in the meaning of the dhatu. Just the action is indicated. Action is denoted. So if you say sleeping or doing something, so dukrunch karane. Karane is karana artha in the sense of doing. So if I want to just talk about the kriyas doing, then karoti. So I just want to talk about karoti arthe. So in the meaning of doing nothing specific, just the activity is being talked about, then bhavi prayoga is used. So for example, supyate. And this we have seen when it is a akarmaka dhatu, then you cannot use karmani prayoga. You can use only bhave prayoga. Similarly, when a karmani sakarmaka dhatu is there, which can take an action, the kriya, the dhatu can take a karma, it can take an object. Still, if in the vivaksha, in the intention, I do not want to convey the karma, then still bhave prayoga can be used. So bhave prayoga is in the are used in two cases. One, when I want to talk about both cases, I just want to talk about the kriya. But if it is an akarmaka dhatu, I have to use bhavya prayoga. I cannot use karmani prayoga at all. And if my intention is to just convey the kriya, then in sakarmaka dhatu also, I cannot use, I can use bhavya prayoga. I need not use karmani prayoga. But the forms, this supyate, supyate is akarmaka dhatu. But let's say I have to say kriyate. Kru dhatu is in the sense of doing something. And I just want to talk about the activity, then I say kriyate. This kriyate, by looking at the form, I cannot make a decision whether it is a karmani usage or bhave usage unless I know the construct of the sentence. So I have to assume that it can be, since kru is a sakarmaka dhatu, I can assume that it can be either bhave or karmani prayoga when I start analyzing the sentence. Then if it is a karmani prayoga, then what is denoted is the karma, and that has to go in first case. So I have to start searching for a word in first case. This is when it is a karmani prayoga. If it is a bhave prayoga, then anyway there will be no karma. So I will not find anything in first case which is denoted by this dhatu. That will be, so therefore kriyate, when there is no karma in the first case, then I can assume that it is bhave prayoga. So I can say doing. I can translate as doing. But if I have to say that, if I find a word in first case, then I say translate as is done. Then it will be bhutakala and it will be a passive voice. This is how I go about understanding the sentence. Both the forms for bhave and for karmani prayoga will be the same. And we have seen that in bhave prayoga and karmani prayoga, it will take the dhatu, whichever dhatu it is, it will take only Atmanepada Pratyaya, whether the dhatu is Atmanepadi or parasmayipadi in karmani prayoga, it will necessarily take the atmanepada pratyaya and the ya. Ya comes and sits between the dhatu sup. For example, sup dhatu and te is the atmanepada pratyaya. Ya comes and sits in between. This is in contrast to kartari prayoga, where the dhatu, which type of dhatu, whether it is a parasmayipadi dhatu or atmanepadi dhatu or ubhayapadi dhatu, that will determine the type of pratyaya that it takes. Parasmayipadi dhatu will take only parasmayipada pratyaya and so on in kartari prayoga. And what goes in first case for kartari prayoga, since karta is denoted, karta goes in first case. I am repeating this because this is the most important aspect of the sentence analysis. Lakara, and obviously lakara is important to identify the declension of the, which is the verb. And once you know the verb, you know the dhatu also, then how do you go about understanding the sentence? What should you look for? Whether the first case is a karma or karta, should you look for a first case at all? That will depend on what kind of prayoga. So you have seen the examples. And what is important then is that if it is karmani prayoga and I want to look at a karta after I have seen the karma, then the karta goes in third case. In bhave prayoga also, karta goes in third case. In kartari prayoga, karta goes in first case. Karma, if there is a karma, it goes in second case. In karmani prayoga, there is another thing. I'll just mention it. If there is a dvikarmaka dhatu, I had mentioned earlier that some dhatus, there are some 16, a set of 16 dhatus, split into 10 and 6 as I remember, they have, there is something called as gauna karma and mukhya karma, the primary and the secondary karma. In karmani prayoga, only in those set of dhatus, what goes in first case will depend on the whether it belongs to the first 10 or the second set of 6. So whether it belongs to the dhatu is the part of 10 or part of 6 in the dvikarmaka dhatu list, based on that both behave exactly opposite. Then primary, in one case primary goes in first case and the secondary goes in second case, and the other just opposite to that. This is just to make a note of it. Like for example, duhu is one dhatu, which gives a form dogdhi in kartari prayoga. So that dogdhi, that form, it matters, as in what goes in first case was what goes in second case, because I say the milk is milked. The milk is milked, and where it is milked, so that the cow is milked and the milk is milked. So cow is also karma, milk is also a karma. So it takes two karmas, and which goes in first case and second case, in those set of dhatus, it's a little tricky to analyze, but I'm just mentioning it, so in case you find such a construct. So let's move on. I just closed with this. If this was not understood, what changes? So how do I say denoted? In kartari prayoga, say pashyati is the form in for drish dhatu, sees. Manushya pashyati, what goes hand in hand with the verb is the karta. So if the karta changes, manushya becomes manushyam, two people, then pashyati will become pashyata. But that is not the case when karma changes. One ghata, two ghatas, three ghatas, one manushya can see one, two or three ghatas, or more than two ghatas. Similarly, two people can see one ghata, two ghatas or multiple ghatas. That does not have an impact on what is being seen, does not have an impact on the number of the declension of the dhatu. Similarly, opposite to that is karmani prayoga. In karmani prayoga drishyate, so there maya drishyate, by me, or manushyena drishyate, by someone it is seen, by a person, a single person, therefore drishyate. Two people see, manushyabhyam drishyate. So that is how the manushyanam manushyabhyam ghata. So ghata drishyate, they based on that, actually just a second, I seem to have messed up here. Ghata, okay, so drishyate, I can say manushyena drishyate, manushyabhyam drishyate. So depending on the karta, the dhatu does not change, the declension, the dhatu does not decline in keeping with the karta, the way it does in kartari prayoga. So yeah, that's what I was saying. I thought I messed up. Okay, so ghata is the karma, and ghata, if one pot is being seen, then I use this the number is singular. Then if I say ghatau, if two ghatas are being seen, then are being seen, that are being seen is said by drishyate. And if more than one ghata, then ghata, more than two ghatas, ghataha drishyante. But it does not change the drishyante, drishyate, drishyate. These forms do not change in keeping with the karta. Karta can be any number. This is where we were, and this is how the analysis of the sentence is. Now just let's look at a few dhatus to get an idea of how the declension changes in kartari prayoga itself. See, parasmai pada dhatu in the first gana, and I have said 1, 4, 6, 10. First gana, fourth gana, sixth gana and tenth gana, we don't have to worry about the anga. Once the anga is formed, then we don't have to worry about the anga being changed by the tipratting pratyas. I had mentioned two, E and U. E and U take guna in the dhatu. If the, based on the gana, the vikarna pratyaya can cause guna. Guna meaning E will become A, U will become O. There is another thing, Ru also undergo change. So I'll just write it down. What is guna? When there is a guna on an anga, any anga, I just open Varaha. Okay, so Gunaha. What is Gunaha and what is Vriddhi? I'll just mention those. Guna letters are A and O. These are guna letters. Vriddhi letters are A, Ai and Au. Okay, and when I say there is a guna on the anga, let's say the dhatu is kru here. Kru is the dhatu, and I say there is a guna. Then what happens? I'll take three, say kru, this kri also, whether, and let's say bhu. So r, e and u. The r, or say, is there a r? So let's say plu. Okay, I'll leave out the lu now. I don't know whether plu is a dhatu, but let's say kru. Whether it is a ru anta or lu. Lu anta, there are these two vowels. What happens is that respectively it will become, I'll give the example, it will become a is the guna. So it can take one of these three, and we have to see which is the closest. So for ru and lu, a is the guna. For e the guna is a. E or e. Dirgha raswa, the guna will be a. This is an example. For example, and here also we'll take an example, and this for u or u, the guna is o. And whenever there is something called as, whenever this is replaced by a, there is un, we'll see what un is. A, E, U, Ru, Ru, so on. We'll see Maheshwara Sutra, then I'll be able to explain what is an. When Ru or Ru, right now see that Ru or Ru is replaced by A or A. A is a Vriddhi letter. So I'll just mention this is a Guna, and Vriddhi also I'll put here itself. Vriddhi will be A, Guna and Vriddhi. I'll say this is Vriddhi, Guna slash Vriddhi. So this is Guna slash Vriddhi. I mentioned what are guna letters, what are vriddhi letters. Among these, what is guna vriddhi here? A is the guna letter for ru or lu, A is the vriddhi letter. A is the guna letter for E or E, and I is the vriddhi letter. Then O is the guna letter for U or U, O is the vriddhi letter. This is how we understand. And I don't want to be technically incorrect, that's why I'm not saying R or R, but what happens is this is R. I'll say R here, or I'll just mention this as for R also. There are okay for both R and R, there's a A or A as a replacement based on whether it takes guna or vriddhi. Now this A or A, when it is replacing R or R, then it will be followed by R or L based on what is the content of R. This R is also a vowel. The way the tongue rolls, there is a little bit of a Refa content. And in L, there is as though a Lakara content. Therefore, whenever Akara or Akara is a replacement for R, then it will necessarily be followed by a Refa. Here, Refa or in this case Refa. So A will become R and A will become R. Similarly, lu, when it is replaced by a, it will be followed by la, al, it will become, or al, or r itself. So anyway, I'll just say that this is the possible replacement. I'll not give an example for this. We'll see when come for this. But here, let's say the ru is, the dhatu is kru. Kru is the dhatu. So what will kru take? Kru will take, this R will become K. So R will become A, therefore K will become K. And K will be followed by Refa. This A, Akara will be followed by Refa. You will get Kar. And here you will get Kar. Guna will be, so Kru, when you say the Kru Anga takes Guna, then Kru will become Kar. And when we say that the Kru takes Vriddhi, then Kru will become Kar. Similarly here, E, Kri, if it is Kri, Raswa or Dirga, Kri, when I say Kri takes Guna, then it will become, this Kri, E will become A, so Kre, it will become Kre, it becomes, it takes a Guna, Kre, or Krai, here the Anga, A will become I, E will become I, E or E will become I, so instead of A as a replacement for guna, you will get I, you will get krai. I am just giving an example. This may or may not be the process that we will see, as in we may not see kri becoming krai, based on the gana we may not see, but I am just giving an example. This kri, although it is a dhatu, here I don't mean in the sense of declension. We are not doing declensions. I am just telling you how the changes happen. In the gana where kri is, there it will not take guna or vriddhi, but I am just saying if something takes a guna, e kara, I am just mentioning the e, or interested in e. Similarly, bhu is replaced by o when there is a guna indicated, or there is a vidhi prescribed, guna is prescribed, then bhu will become bho. And if it is a vriddhi, then it will become bhau. Okay, this is for understanding. We may not see bhau being happening, but bho we may see. Kre and krei we may not see. We'll see elsewhere, not with kri. This is just an example. Okay, but just to say this also, let's say plu is there. I'll add it anyway. This also will become, anyway, it's difficult to talk about this form. I don't want to touch this. It may be erroneous, so I don't want to talk about this right now. We'll see, if we see an example, just remember that this is the process when we say guna or vriddhi happens on the anga. Now here you look at it, kru. Yeah, here glamlu is there. So glamlu, but it takes a cha adesha, therefore we don't see this lu taking becoming something else. Now look at the example in the first gana. These are all first gana dhatus. In first gana dhatus, kru. Kru is this kru, and there is a sha. Krishna, and this anuswara is an indicatory letter. The dhatu is really krish. Krish is the dhatu, vilekhane, to draw or to flow. When I say there is a guna, because first gana, the dhatu can take a guna. And in guna, what happens is that if the last letter cannot take a guna, if it is a consonant, and a consonant cannot take a guna, then what happens is that the upada meaning the penultimate letter, the earlier letter can take guna. If it can take guna, it will take guna. So it is not ruvanta, it is not kru. Here we saw kru. This dhatu is kru. But if it is krish, then krish will become, this shakara cannot take guna. Therefore, ru will take guna and you will get kar. The kru is replaced by, this kru is replaced by kar when it takes guna. And shakara is there, so you will get karsha. This is how we have to see the forms. So when you see karsha and you add tip, then you will get karshati. The form is karshati. This karshati, when you are analyzing, if you see karshati, then you remove the ti, which is the tip, you remove ti, and then you get karsha. And what do you know, how do you find out the dhatu? You say karsha, you reverse engineer it, you say kar, shakara is the last letter, sha, a is sitting here, which is the gana vikarna pratyaya. So the dhatu is karsh, karsh, you have landed to karsh. And karsh, you reverse engineer by saying that this shakara cannot have become, is not a guna letter. What is a guna is a. So kar, in that what can happen, ar. So what can become ar? Only ru can become ar. Therefore, you say you replace this a with ru and you say kru. Kru is the kru. The kar letter is actually kr. The kar pronunciation kar is actually kru. And shakara is sitting right here. So you say krish is the dhatu. Krish is the dhatu. This is how you land by reverse engineering karshati. If you see karshati form, the dhatu is krish. Similarly, gum. Gum is gato in meaning of gati, in movement. It means to move, to go. And it becomes gach. The anga becomes gacha. And you add ti, you see gachati. You get gachati because ti cannot cause any guna or vriddhi to the anga in first gana. First, fourth, sixth and tenth. So you just keep on looking at the forms in first gana dhatus. If you can form the anga, then you just add the tip pratyaya together. So gach. This gum will become gach and gach will become gachati. Similarly, char will become charati. Jeev will become jeevati. Drishi, drish takes a pash. Adesha we have seen. Drish takes pashin kartari prayoga. Therefore, you don't get drishyati, you get prashyati. So, pash, pashyati. Nam becomes namati. So, anga, you look at what is the dhatu. Dhatu, the content is nam. Nam becomes namati. Ni becomes ni. Now, ni is the dhatu. So like kri, this kri should, in guna it will become kre. So similarly, ni will become ne. And when it becomes ne being followed by a, which is the, this, let's say here, ni is the dhatu. Ni is the dhatu. Ni will become ne by guna. And then when it takes a guna, this is followed by a. A is basically the first guna, vikarna pratyaya, and there is a tip. Tip is there, which is ti. So ne plus a sandhi is nay. This a will become nay by sandhi rule. We'll see sandhi rules. And then nay, therefore nay plus a plus ti is nayati. You will get naya. Naya is the anga. And ti you add, you get nayati. Similarly, pat will become patati. Pat will become patati. Just have to add them together. You have to look at the guna, whether guna is possible. If it is a R, E or O, U anta dhatu, then it will take guna. If it is a consonant ending dhatu, then you look at the penultimate, the second last letter. And the second last letter also can take guna. Thereby, you will get the anga. And anga once you get, you add akara. If there is a sandhi, you do sandhi. And then just add T. Once you get the anga. So, pat plus A will be patha. The A is the gana vikarna pratya, you will get patati. Similarly, patati, bud will become, see, bud, dhakara cannot take guna, ukara can take guna, the second last letter. Therefore, it will become ukara guna is bo, o. So, you will get, instead of bu, you will get bo. Bodh will become bodha, bodhati. Bhu will become bho. By guna, it will become bho, and bho plus a, u has become o by guna, and o plus a sandhi is va. Av is the sandhi. So you will get bhav. Bhav plus a is bhava. and it will decline bhavati. Vas will become vasati, sta will become, sta has a replacement of tish, tisht, it will get, sta becomes tishtati, sta, sta dhatu is tishtati. So some important dhatus she has mentioned which will keep on recurring, sta, kru, all these dhatus keep on recurring. Smru, smru will become, ru, ru, the guna for ru is a, and the content after refa is added it will become ar. So smru will become smar. And smara will be, after you add a, the gana vikrana pratyaya will get smara, and smara plus ti will be smarati. This is the first gana. Similarly, fourth gana, sixth gana, and 1, 4, 6, 10, and 10th gana. 10th gana, the specialty is that it will take e and it can cause vriddhi. So chur will become chori, we had seen, and chori plus a, then it will decline like first gana. So all angas which end in a, there is no guna on the anga after the tip pratyaya is added, ting pratyaya is added. So fourth gana asdhatu, asdhatu, fourth gana vikarna pratyaya is here. So you just have to add as plus ya is asya, asyati, nash will become nashyati, tush tushyati, nrit, nrit will become nrityati. Because the content here in the dhatu there is no guna. Due to fourth gana pratyaya being here, shya, shan it is actually, it cannot cause guna to the anga. We have to look at the chart which we had seen earlier. Just refer to the chart whether or not it can take guna. So nrit, nritya, just here has to be added. Push, pushya, pushyati, nrityati, pushyati, muhiyati, shushyati. So you just have to add them together, and there is no guna here also in the dhatu, there is no guna here also in the anga. Therefore you just have to add them together in the fourth gana. Sixth gana, 1, 4, 6, 10 we said. So 1, 4, 6, 10, sixth gana see ish, 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 this ish, just like gum becomes gach, ish becomes ich, ichchati, ichchati, one desires, dish, dishyati. So, based on, of course, I don't know whether it will be Atmane Pada, so here Ubhaya Pada. So, it can become Dishati as well as here Ichchati only because it is Parasmi Pada. If it is Ubhaya Padi, you will get Dishati or Dishate. Both possibilities are there. The Parasmi declension is also possible and Atmane declension is also possible. Here, Parasmi Pada, you get Prichati. Much Prichati asks. So prach, prach becomes prich. There is a refa. This refa becomes u. That is an adesha. So there are some rules which will change in dhatu when you decline. So those are special cases like prach. Prach will not become prachati. It will become prichati. But this is not guna or reverse. The reverse of guna. It is just that this there is some rule, grammar rule, which makes prach as prich. For practical purposes, if we consider prich as dhatu, it's not an issue. But the thing is that you will not find prich as a dhatu. If you search for it, prich will not be available, prach will be available. But we'll make out. Generally, there are a lot of people who can't make out the difference between ru and r. That's another story. So much much munchati, again nakaras comes and sits here. So you have to look at similarity. So much can become muncha, much munchati. With Vindati, there can be a something called as a Numagama that can come and sit in between. That is a possibility. So if you see Vind, Vindati as a form, then don't look for Dhatu Vind. You may find it in modern dictionaries, you may find Vind also. But actually in the Dhatu Pata, it is Vid. Nakara comes and sits here due to some rule. That rule is here based on what is here in the Dhatu Pata, what is the real Dhatu with the packaging. Based on this packaging, the rules are formed. Sprish will become sprishati, lik likhati, vish vishati, srij srijati. Now see, if you see the dhatu in 1, 4, 6 and 10, it is very easy to identify except for guna. If you see guna, if you understand guna, then you can reverse engineer and understand the dhatu. And then look up the meaning and form the translation. It is easy. So you have to know prayoga, kartari prayoga, karmani prayoga. If it is karmani prayoga, you don't have to look at the this at all. You don't have to look at the gana at all. Only ya you remove and you will get the dhatu. You remove the te atam ja, the atmane pada ting pratyaya, you get the anga. Here you remove, you get the dhatu. Similarly here, in kartari prayoga, you have to look at the gana vikarna pratyaya. You understand the gana vikarna pratyaya and you understand guna, then you reverse engineer the guna and you get the dhatu. It's, if you do it for a few times, you will get it. This is the, so we'll, these are the examples. And similarly, other ganas also, we will not go into details of other ganas. I show, gave you some examples of what kind of dhatus are there. Now, let's look at the subanta now. Tinganta we have seen enough. Now, another part I'll mention, so when you're analyzing, the dhatu is not necessarily seen without a, as in just a plain dhatu with a vikarna pratyaya and the thing pratyas. There may be prefixes also. So prefixes, there can be multiple, one or more than one prefix, and these are the general set of prefixes. Pra, para, apa, sam, anu. So these are called as upasargas. These upasargas, when added to the dhatus, they can change the meaning. There are various possibilities. Upasargas, when you add, say when you add the upasargas, suffixes, prefixes can, what can they do? They can keep the not change, or they can keep the same meaning of the dhatu. It may not change. So, may not change. One possibility. Other possibility is gives a completely, can give a completely opposite meaning. Can give a, or extend the meaning as in related meaning, extend the meaning to a related meaning, some extension, or it can do something else completely, can give completely unrelated meaning. So these are the all sorts of possibilities, and there may be more, as in what it can do, we don't know. So upasarga is one of the most difficult thing to understand, and that we know only through the looking at the dictionary as to what are the possibilities of meanings. Because we cannot say that pra in one case may be one thing, in another case it may be another thing, and the based on which dhatu it is added to, it may mean something else. So all those possibilities are there, pra, para, apa, sam, anu, av, ava, nis, nir. Now nis and nir can be related, this nis and nir can be taken as separate or they can be same, but we don't know what meaning change will be there, whether it is in the swartha meaning, as in the same meaning is there or opposite is there. So we have to be careful when a upasarga is there, we cannot take the dhatu artha as it is. We have to look for some dhatu pata which gives the meaning of, like Michikaji has made a dhatu pata which gives the meaning with upasargas. With upasargas, what is the possible change in meaning? These are dus, dur, vi, ang, ni, adhi, api, ati, su, ud, abhi, prati, pari and upa. These are the prefixes which can be added to a dhatu, and they can, she gives an example, they can change the meaning. For example, bhu dhatu. You look at bhu dhatu, bhu is to be. But anupurvaka bhu means anu is before bhu, that is, it is a prefix, then you get anubhu, and anubhu is to experience. That's how you get anubhava, anubhuti, these words are there. Those are anupurvaka bhu. Abhipurvaka bhu, abhi is a, then abhibhu will be to overwhelm. Now what is the connection of to be and to experience? What is the connection of to be and to overwhelm? We can't see the connection, but what it means is that the upasarga can do a lot of things in the change of meaning. Prabhu, see Prabhu is to appear. And Sambhu, what is Sambhu? Sambhu is to be possible. So Sambhavana, Sambhava, all these words are derived from Sampurvaka Bhudhatu. But some, see, to be possible and to be, there is some connection. sometimes there is no connection at all. 2B and 2 appear also, there is some connection. But 2B and 2 overwhelm, we can't see the connection. Ahru, now see, Ahru, Hru Dhatu is to take away. But Ahru, Ahara, you get word Ahara. Ahru is to eat. Ud plus A plus Hru, Udahru is an Udaharana. You get example. The example is Udaharana. But now, what we have to understand is one meaning we can understand. But what is the Dhatu? How do you find the Dhatu? So, what we do is that if you see Udaharana, Udaharana or Udahruti, Udaharati, Udaharati, then T you remove. This is the verb. T you remove, you get Udahru. Udahar you get, and then you reverse engineer the guna Udahar into Udahru. So you know Udahru is the Anga. Then which is the Dhatu? Udahru is not the Dhatu. Then you see whether I can remove Uda. Ut plus A plus Hru. So you remove Ut and you remove A, you get Hru, which is the Dhatu. Then you can look up the meaning of the Dhatu. Then we can look up the possible meanings of Ut and A, and then try to make out the sense of the Udahru when prefixes are added. This is how the analysis is. Okay, now I just wanted to talk about some the meanings we have seen are Karaka Arthas, not all Vibhakti Arthas. Let's look at the other Vibhakti Arthas for all the Subanta Padas, the cases. Okay, so pratyas, just a recap. I don't know whether we have seen this, but this is the these are the pratyas. Su au jas am out shas tabhyam vis ne bhyam vyas nyasibhyam vyas nyas os am ni os sup. And prathama the sambodhana is when you address a person directly in a noun, then su au jas are the same prathama vibhakti pratyas added for sambodhana also. The meanings we have seen now, all these are with the packaging, with the ith letters. When you remove the ith letters, the content is something else. And nouns to decline with the suaujas is little difficult, especially with akaranta pullinga. Instead, we have looked at the forms directly. Ramaha, Ramo, Ramaha, Ramam, Ramo, Raman, Ramena, Ramabhyam, Ramaihi, Ramaya, Ramabhyam, Ramebhya, Ramat Ramabhyam Ramebhya, Ramasya Ramayo Ramana, Rame Ramayo Rameshu, and He Rama, where there is no Visarga, He Rama, He Ramo, He Ramaha, which is Sambodhana. The meanings we have seen, Karaka meanings we have seen, whether she's listed it as a table, I'm looking at a table. Okay, so let's look at the summary table. What are the Karaka Vibhaktis? Okay, I think she may have given earlier itself. We'll look at this and then look at summary. So, what is the first case? What is the first case used for Karaka Vibhakti and non-Karaka Vibhaktis? This is how we have to divide. Karaka Vibhakti we have already seen. I'm giving the extension of other shades of meanings possible for Vibhaktis. Karaka Vibhakti for first case is what? Karta in Kartari Prayoga, Karma in Karmani Prayoga. So, Karta in, that is a Karaka Vibhakti. Karta in Kartari Prayoga, like Devadattaha Pashyati. Devadatta like Ramaha. Ramaha Pashyati, Devadattaha Pashyati. Devadatta is first case, Pashyati is Kartari Prayoga. Karta goes in first case. This is a Karaka Vibhakti. So, Karta in first case. If the Drishyante, so if you say Drishyante is the form, Drishyante we know is a Karmani Prayoga and it is plural, Drishyante, are seen. So you translate as are seen. What are seen? You look over the first case, Gajaha. So Gajaha is plural for Gaja, Gaja Shabda, Akaranta, Pullinga, Gaja Shabda, elephant. So elephants are seen. This is the Karma in going in first case. It is a Karmani Prayoga. In Karmani Prayoga, Karma goes in first case. This is the Karaka Vibhakti for first case. What is the non-karaka vibhakti? Non-karaka vibhakti for first case is Sambodhana. He Rama, Mam Pahi. Pahi means protect. This is the Lot Lakara. pahi, please protect me, it's a request, please protect me, and it is madhyama purusha ekvachana, you protect me. So you have to look, you say that protect me, when you are saying it is a second person, I say you protect me. Who is that you? When I call out a person, I'll say hey Rama, sambodhana, hey Rama protect. So actually protect me is not there, pahi is there, only protect. You start the analysis by saying protect, please protect. So it is a please protect is a kartari prayoga. You are saying, telling someone, please protect. The meaning of please protect is sitting in pahi itself. Then who are you talking to? It is pahi is an address to a second person. So that second person can be tvam, as in you. Directly I say you protect, or it can be O Bhagavan protect. So O Rama protect. Then who should he protect? That is the karma. That protect will take a karma. To protect, protect what? Protect what? Protect whom? When you ask that question, akanksha is there. You supply a second case. Mam is the second case of aham, me. You protect me. So hey Rama, you protect me. What is hey Rama? This is sambodhana prathama. This is the non-karaka vibhakti of first case. If you have to say in plural, hey devaha, o devas, o devatas, please protect me. So when I say o devas, then o devas protect me, pahi in plural, pa dhatu rakshane, in the sense of protection, it will become pata in plural. O devas, please protect me. So you see, kartari prayoga, who is the karta of the action of protecting? That is the deva. The Lord. So devas plural, when it becomes plural, the pahi becomes pata. It goes hand in hand with, the dhatu goes hand in hand, the verb goes hand in hand with the declension, with the karta. So that is the non-karaka vibhakti in first case. Dvitiya is karma. Dvitiya is always karma. It can be gauna karma or mukhya karma, but whether kartari prayoga or karmani prayoga, it will be karma. So you see karma, as in if it is a secondary karma or a primary, if there are two karmas, so karma in karmani prayoga will go in first case, but we have seen there are dvikarmaka dhatus, if there are dvikarmaka dhatus, then it can be, in second case you may see another karma, first case you will see definitely see a karma, but in second case also you may see a karma, only in case of dvikarmaka dhatus, otherwise it is only in kartari prayoga that karma will go in second case, because otherwise in karmani prayoga, if it is the dhatu can take only one karma, that will go only in the first case in karmani prayoga. So that's why she is mentioned in kartari prayoga, karma in second case is what is a karaka vibhakti. Like devadattaha pashyati, pashyati you say, he sees. What does who sees? Devadatta sees. So devadatta goes in first case, which you have seen in the earlier example. But devadatta, what does he see? He sees one elephant, two elephants, three elephants. That can be anything. So gajam pashyati, gajau pashyati, or gajan pashyati. This will not change the declension of the dhatu. So this gajan is a karaka vibhakti. It is karma in second case. Second case for kartari prayoga. This karaka vibhakti. Now, I'm not going to talk about other possibilities, it may confuse, but there are fourth case possibilities there, but that is only for a destination. So Devadatta Gramam Gachati is possible. Devadatta Gachati goes where? To a village. When you say to a village, that to in Gam Dhatu, that is a destination and it is a karma. So Gramam, second case, Gramam Gachati. Now fourth case is also possible, Gramaya Gachati, that's a this is a possibility that the karma goes in fourth case in certain cases. What is a non-karaka vibhakti? Non-karaka vibhakti in second case is, there are some words which are indeclinables, called as avyaya. Indeclinables are called as avyaya, and those avyayas we say they govern a particular case. There are certain set of avyayas which govern a second case. There are certain which govern third case. There are certain which govern third and sixth case. Certain govern third case, sixth case, second case and fifth case. So multiple possibilities are there. There is an option. Here prati. Prati governs second case. So moksha. Bhavati, there is what? Icha. first case you have to search for first case in kartari prayoga for the karta इच्छा भवति there is desire what is the desire so prati towards there is a desire towards so akanksha is towards what is the desire so towards prati there is a desire इच्छा prati इच्छा भवति so towards something there is a desire what is that something the prati will govern second case that something will go in second case so moksham prati इच्छा भवति अस्ति मोक्षम प्रति इच्छा अस्ति मोक्षम विल गो इन सेकंड केस मोक्ष शब्द विल गो इन सेकंड केस हियर देयर इज डिजायर टुवर्ड्स लिबरेशन दिस इज द नॉन कारक विभक्ति विल सी मोर ऑफ नॉन कारक विभक्तिज बिकॉज वी हैव सीन कारक विभक्तिज बट विल नाउ वी लुक एट एग्जांपल्स एंड देन वंस वी अंडरस्टैंड द शेड्स ऑफ मीनिंग्स ऑफ सुबंता वी हैव सीन लिटिल बिट ऑफ तिंगंता देन वी कैन लुक एट सम कंस्ट्रक्ट्स ऑफ सेंटेंसेस एंड मूव टू तत्वबोध विल लुक सम संधि ऑल्सो when words come together in close proximity in pronunciation, what changes can happen? We look at some, not all. We look at vowel sandhi. We look at very little of the hal sandhi, which is consonants when they come together, what happens? Om Shanti Shanti Shanti.